Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. It's been a packed week in the Linux world, from a massive new kernel release that might be our next long-term support version, to some huge news about the future of the KDE Plasma desktop. And on top of all that, Linus Torvalds himself got a new PC, and his choice of graphics card is, well, it's definitely turning some heads. We've got a lot to cover, so grab your coffee, and let's dive into the biggest Linux news from the last week of November 2025. First up, the big one. Linux Kernel 6.18 is officially out, and the timing suggests it's a strong contender for the 2025 long-term support, or LTS release. This is a big deal because an LTS kernel is guaranteed to receive maintenance and security updates for at least 2 years, sometimes longer, making it the go-to choice for servers, embedded systems, and anyone who values stability. So what's inside? Well, this release is packed. One of the most talked about changes is the removal of the Bcachefs file system from the mainline kernel. It's not gone completely, but it's now only available as a DKMS module, which is an interesting development for a file system that was only merged a year ago. But the bigger story is the sheer volume of new drivers and features. We're seeing the first implementation of a Rust-based driver, the Rust Binder driver, which is a massive milestone for the Rust in the Kernel initiative. There's also a new device mapper target called DMPcache, which lets you use persistent memory as a super fast cache for slower block devices. Think Optane, but for any block device. And the hardware support? It's massive. You've got initial support for Apple's M2 Pro, Max, and Ultra SoCs, which is an enormous win for running Linux on modern Apple hardware. There's also support for the audio jacks on the PlayStation DualSense controller, and even haptic feedback on some HID touchpads. It's these little quality of life improvements that really make a difference in the day-to-day user experience. On the performance side, there are improvements to swap performance, NFS server scaling, and UDP receive performance. There's also a new feature called Sheaves that's designed to improve kernel memory allocation performance. It's a lot of under-the-hood work, but it all adds up to a faster, more efficient kernel. So while we wait for Greg Croa Hartman to confirm the LTS status officially, Kernel 6.18 looks like a fantastic release that will power our systems for years to come. Now, from the heart of Linux to the distros that bring it to life. It was a busy week for distro releases, with some of the biggest names in the community pushing out fresh updates. First up, for all you rolling release fans, Arch Linux released its December 2025 ISO. The Linux 6.17.9 kernel powers this one, and comes with the new Arch Install 3.0.14. The installer has a neat new feature that lets you install the UEFI bootloader to a removable location, which is super handy for creating portable Arch installs. For the enterprise crowd, Rocky Linux 9.7 is now available. This is a big one, with a significant focus on security. It includes support for post-quantum cryptography, PQC, a significant step towards future-proofing our systems against the threat of quantum computers. It also ships with a ton of updated packages, including Node.js 24, GCC 15, and .NET 10. And for those of you who like to live on the bleeding edge, the November ISO for Cache OS is out, with improved hardware detection and a smoother installation experience. Solus 4.8 also dropped, with the latest from the GNOME and KDE Plasma desktops. It's great to see so much activity across the board, from the DIY spirit of Arch to the rock-solid stability of Rocky. There's genuinely a Linux for everyone. Now, let's talk about the desktop, because there's a seismic shift on the horizon for KDE users. Alright, let's talk about the desktop, because this is a big one. The KDE project has officially announced that KDE Plasma 6.8 will be Wayland-only, completely dropping the X11 session. Now, before anyone panics, this isn't happening overnight. Plasma 6.8 is still a couple of years away, expected in early 2027. And for those of you on long-term support distros, the X11 session will continue to be supported until then. But this is a clear signal that the future of KDE Plasma is Wayland. And honestly, it's about time. X11 has been the backbone of the Linux desktop for over 3 decades, but it's carrying significant technical debt. Wayland is more secure, more efficient, and offers better support for modern hardware features like high refresh rate displays and fractional scaling. For most users, this transition will be seamless. The vast majority of KDE users are already on Wayland, and X11 apps will continue to work just fine through X-Wayland. And for gamers, the news is even better. Wayland has made considerable strides in gaming performance, with better support for adaptive sync, HDR, and high refresh rate multi-monitor setups. Even NVIDIA's proprietary drivers are playing nice with Wayland now. So while it's the end of an era for X11, it's also the beginning of a new one for KDE Plasma. And it's looking brighter than ever. And for a little trip down memory lane, the Common Desktop Environment, or CDE, saw a new release after 2 years. CDE 2.5.3 is here, and it's a fantastic reminder of where the Linux desktop came from. It's a fun, retro experience, and it's fantastic to see it still being actively developed. From the desktop to the hardware that powers it. And this week, we got a peek into the personal setup of the one and only Linus Torvalds. Alright, let's talk hardware, because this is a fun one. Linus Sebastian from Linus Tech Tips built a new PC for Linus Torvalds, and the whole thing is on video. It's a great watch, but the most interesting part for me was Torvalds' GPU choice. He went with an Intel Arc B580. Now, this is fascinating for a couple of reasons. First, he didn't go with an NVIDIA card, which isn't a huge surprise given his history with the company, but he also didn't go with an AMD Radeon card, which is what most people would consider the obvious choice for a Linux build, thanks to their excellent open source drivers. So why Arc? Well, Torvalds have always been pragmatists. He wants hardware that works with the mainline kernel, without any fuss. And that's exactly what Intel has been delivering with its open source graphics stack. The drivers are in the kernel, well-maintained, and work. It's a testament to the incredible work Intel has been doing on its Linux drivers. And speaking of drivers, Kernel 6.18 also brings the new Tier driver, a Rust-based driver for ARM's Mali CSF GPUs. This is a joint effort from Collabora, Google, and ARM, and it's another big step forward for Rust in the kernel. On the community front, a 15-line patch from a GitHub user has enabled NVIDIA GPU support on the Raspberry Pi 5 and other Rockchip-based single-board computers. It's a fantastic example of the power of open-source collaboration. So, a big week for hardware, and a fascinating look into the mind of the man who started it all. Now for a look at how AI is making its way into the Linux world. Canonical, the company behind Ubuntu, has revealed that it's using AI to help modernize the Ubuntu error tracker. They're using GitHub Copilot to help port the web UI to modern standards and migrate the backend from a deprecated database driver. This is an exciting, practical application of AI. It's not a flashy, user-facing feature, but it's helping to improve the infrastructure that makes Ubuntu a stable and reliable operating system. It's a smart way to use AI to tackle technical debt and free up developers to work on new features. And finally, let's wrap up with some fantastic news from the gaming world. The Steam Hardware Survey for November 2025 is out, and Linux has reached a new all-time high of 3.20% market share. This is a huge milestone, and it's a clear sign that Linux gaming is not just a niche. It's a growing and thriving ecosystem. The Steam Deck has obviously been a massive catalyst for this. Still, it's also a testament to the incredible work being done by the entire community, from the developers at Valve working on Proton, to the Mesa driver developers and all the community members who contribute to making Linux an excellent platform for gaming. It's an exciting time to be a Linux gamer. So what a week. Let's quickly recap. So there you have it. Linux Kernel 6.18 is here, and it's a beast. KDE is paving the way for a Wayland-only future. Linus Torvalds is rocking an Intel Arc GPU, and Linux gaming is stronger than ever. What do you think about all this news? Are you excited about the future of the Linux desktop? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I read every single one. If you enjoyed this video and want to stay up to date on all things Linux, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. It really helps us out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.